DaVinci Resolve has some really nice tools to do tracking within your video. I'm going to use these tracking tools to show you how to put words on top of a water surface. You can do this also to place images or video on any surface in DaVinci Resolve. All right, so let's jump right in. I'm in the edit page today. If you need to get there, hit shift and the number 4 on your keyboard. So I have a timeline here. I'm going to drag my footage right onto the timeline. Ideally, what your shot has is something to create some markers with some contrast. This one has a number of great options here on the edges, so I can create a nice plane in this area here. So once I have my shot in the timeline, I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to say open in Fusion page. So with my media wand selected, I'm going to hit the shift spacebar and I'm going to type in track. So I'm going to use the basic tracker. This one's really easy to use. Go ahead and add that into my node pattern here. So I have tracker one here, and I want to do some changes here before I track it. So let's go to operation first, and I want to do a corner positioner, and this looks okay for now. And so I want to go to best match, pattern center is good. I want to lower this tolerance way down so I have a really accurate track here. So 0.0003, that's pretty good. So these are my track points, and I'm going to need to set those on something I want to track. So make sure that your position of your timeline is to the far left so you can start and go all the way through your timeline. So let's go ahead and start moving these. And I think it's easier if you go up here and you select a different color. In this case, I've got a lot of blue in this scene, so I'm going to select the blue so I can see where my contrast is. So what I want to do is create a plane on top of this water here. So let's go ahead. If you grab the upper left corner of these track markers, you can move them here. And so I want to find something that's pretty good right there. Then grab the bottom corner, and then you can resize kind of that tracker. Same with the outside. This is going to be the overlap area. So that's one. So now I want to repeat this procedure for each of the four corners to create a really great track in this water area. Okay, so the way that my text is going to be laid out, so if you look at track 1, 2, 3, 4, it's going to be laid out kind of on that plane. So this is that little inlet here, and it creates a follow of that plane there, which is pretty good. So when I lay my words out, I don't have to do a lot of manipulation of the text. We can do that, and I'll show you quickly how to do that. But if you lay out your plane and you're able to get track points within that plane, it's a lot easier in the end here. Okay, so I have my track point set, and right now it's on default. It's going to track based on the color here on the luminance. And since I set it up with that blue, I'm just going to track it on that blue track. All right, so I'm at the far left again on my timeline, and I want to just go ahead and hit track. And it's going to track through all of the frames in my clip. It's going to try to hold those positions. This is the free version, so if you have the free or studio version, it's going to work really well for you. So that took about 27 seconds because I had the tolerance way down. It'd be faster if I move that up. Okay, you can see my track lines here, and it created keyframes on all these positions here. So that's good. Let's go ahead and give myself some space here for the node area. And I want to go ahead and just put text in there. I'm going to use the text plus. Connect it into the foreground. So this is Vernazza, Italy, so I'm going to go ahead and type that in. You can see it appear kind of in the center of my track area. So I want to make that quite a bit bigger. And if you go too big, I'll demonstrate. If you go outside of your tracking area, it's going to kind of disappear here. So just keep that in mind when you're setting up your track. So that's pretty big. I'll take a look at that. And I'm going to move this down using my layout positioning here. Get it right on the edge there so we can see it really nice. And one more thing I want to do, I'm going to go back to my tracker here, and under operation, I want to change the apply mode to soft light. So that's just going to show that kind of that shadow there. But what it does do with water, which is really cool, is we can see the waves and we can see other things through that lettering. And I'll demonstrate here. Let's turn the viewer back to color here. And actually, we'll just go back to the edit page. Okay, so it's going to take a few seconds to get this render cache built up. If your bar is red, then it's kind of just building the cache on the disk. Once it's blue, you can look at this in real time. So that's what it looks like. I'll zoom in here so you can really take a look at it. So you can see we get that nice, the water flow through there. And even the boat really kind of going over there. It's going to go right over the lettering, which is kind of cool. So that's really the way to do it. It's pretty simple here in Resolve to use just the regular tracker. And I want to go back here. I mentioned having to move the text around if you couldn't get a track on the plane that you were looking for. And so what you want to do, go ahead and select your text here, and we have some options under layout and transform. You can see rotation here is an option. And so I can make some adjustments on the rotation of this text here if you want to get it in a certain spot. And under transform, make sure you change this to words or lines if you have multiple words, so you can select the whole word and you can make changes along the X, Y, and Z axis. And like I said, if you get a good track here, you won't have to do that manipulation. You can even change the shear here of the angle of the text and different things like that. So going back to the text color, we can add color to this. It'll look a little different. You can see what I'm trying to do here. I wouldn't go that bold. Maybe something light like that wouldn't look too bad. You can still see the water because we're using the composition mode that we're using is correct. Or we could do a really light blue, something like that. Yeah, so I think that works really well in Resolve. And like I said, using the free version or the studio version, and it's just using that simple tracker. I'm not using a planar tracker. I'm just using a corner positioning using the regular tracker, which is built into the free version, which is awesome. So once we get a good track, we can add text. We can add other things on there if you'd like. You can add images or video on, you know, faces or surfaces, no problem. Yeah, so hopefully that was helpful for you. If you got a minute, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, go ahead and post them. I'll try to help you through. But otherwise, take care, everybody. Appreciate it.